Callie Lewis. You're watching Geek Brief TV. This is Brief 624. I've had more conversations than I can count on all my fingers and all my toes where someone just randomly started saying good things about Amazon.com. I'm sure it has its haters, but mostly people just seem to love the Amazon shopping experience. I think a big reason for that is that it was founded by Jeff Bezos, who just comes across as a genuinely nice person who loves what he does for a living. When the whole 1984 debacle happened back in July, where Amazon removed copies of the famous George Orwell book from Amazon's Kindle, people got upset. Jeff Bezos issued what might be the best apology of all time, but now Amazon has gone even further to make the situation right with owners of the pulled Kindle version of 1984. Customers can choose to have a legally published version of the book re-delivered for free, or they can receive an Amazon.com gift certificate or a check for $30. Good looking out, Amazon! If you're going to get into the secondary battery pack for iPhones business, you have to distinguish your offering from the rest. USB Fever has one that does just that. Not only does it extend usage time for an iPhone or iPhone 3GS, it also adds an internal USB cable. The real wow factor comes, though, from its second SIM card support. If you travel a lot, you very well may have two SIM cards on different networks, and although it's very easy to swap SIM cards in an iPhone, you risk losing or damaging one. With the 3-in-1 external battery with dual SIM function for iPhone 3G, 3GS, you can keep both SIM cards at the ready and just switch between the two. While we wait for Apple to release a touchpad or Mike Arrington to start selling the Crunch Pad, Toshiba is showing off a 7-inch tablet called the Journey. It's exactly the type of device internet addicted types like me have been looking forward to having. It's made to consume all types of internet content, from photos on Flickr, blogs, web video, Facebook updates, music, and websites. It runs Windows CE 6.0 Pro, so I'm guessing it isn't very powerful. It also doesn't look to be multi-touch, but it is light and small and will be a great way to watch Geek Brief TV when it's released later this year for around $350. What's better than a video camera with an external mic input? A video camera with an XLR mic input. It's a professional feature and may be unnecessary for casual shooters, but if you're shooting video to share with strangers, you want the best audio options you could afford. The biggest downside of pro-level equipment, though, is that it tends to be mammoth compared to the gear carried around by consumers. Except JVC sent a GYHM100U for us to try, and I'll be taking it to CDN Atlanta later next week. It shoots to two SDHC cards hidden behind this little door here. So with this camera, we have an awesome size. The camera's small. It weighs 3 pounds. Even better than that, it creates a QuickTime file that is natively ready for Final Cut. You plug it in and get to work immediately. Now, here's the piece de resistance. It comes with this handle that slides onto the top and plugs in to provide two XLR inputs with optional phantom power and manual audio control. You guys will get to see the results next week after CDN gets underway. Thanks for watching and thanks for supporting The Brief by using service provided by our sponsors. AngiesList.com/geek is one I used again this week. When you have to pick a contractor to do work on your house, AngiesList.com helps you find someone you can trust, and my code GEEK saves you 25% off the cost of a membership. I'm Callie Lewis. Have a great weekend.